Good evening, friends. It's always a privilege to answer your questions related to Bible, science, evolution, and also the reliability of the Christian faith. This evening, I have a letter from a young person who has asked me about a recent claim in news media that an eyewitness who witnessed Lord Jesus Christ and his miracles wrote a book, and that handwritten book has been discovered by a certain professor. According to this news, a historian by the name of Marcus Velius wrote a document, and that he was an eyewitness of the miracles of Christ. It is said that a certain professor, Ignazio Peruzzi, recently discovered it when he was going through first century documents. The news, which was posted in a blog and then on Facebook, along with the picture of a very ancient handwritten document, captivated the attention of people so much that this news has been shared more than 25,000 times on Facebook, which is an all-time high record for any Christian news. And it is also estimated that more than 500 blogs have been written about this discovery. What is the truth? Have we finally discovered a document from the time of Christ? Can Christian apologists and Christians use this document to support the historicity of miracles which are recorded in the books of Gospel? Well, I wish that this were a solid proof, but I wish to remind you that this news is a complete hoax, a complete deception. Just as that story about a certain NASA computer that discovered a missing day in the universe, and the story about certain people who went into a deep mine shaft and discovered hell and sounds from hell. In the same way, this news is also a complete hoax and a complete deception. You might be surprised. Well, here are the facts. Actually, the news first appeared on a website known as worldnewsdailyreport.com. And they very clearly say that all news articles contained within World Daily Report News.com are fiction and are presumably fake news. Any resemblance to truth is purely coincidental. They very clearly, they have posted this disclaimer on the home page of their website. Yet, without reading the disclaimer, Christians just look at any fake news and they simply circulate it. That is how this news has circulated worldwide. Actually, no such discovery has been made. No scholar has made such a claim. And what is more, that handwritten manuscript which is shown there is a very well-known manuscript. It is known as the Vinolanda tablets. They have been known to scholars now for almost two centuries. And what is there in that document has no connection with Christ. It is something entirely different. So what they did was, they picked up an ancient manuscript, they picked a photograph of a man, made a news that is completely fiction, posted on a site where the disclaimer very clearly says that everything posted here is fiction, and left it. And Christians, without examining the fine print on that website, assumed it to be truth and simply circulated it. Can you imagine 25,000 shares? Please remember, we don't need fiction to support the Bible. There is so much fact around from the world of science, from the world of archaeology, from the world of history, and from the world of discovery, and also from the world of handwritten manuscripts in support of the Bible, that we do not need this kind of fictitious news. Please be very careful. don't spread fiction. If a news seems too good to be true, or if a news seems too exciting, particularly if it is a news about some discovery made just a few days or weeks ago, be careful, wait for some time, ask some Christian apologist who can study it carefully and who can certify that the news is true. So my friends, all this news about a scholar who discovered a handwritten manuscript from first century, written by a person who was an eyewitness to the miracles of Christ, is absolutely false. Please do not circulate it. Send your questions. I'll try to answer as many of them as fast as possible. God bless you.